So I'm like
shucking the corn with this easy peeler.
Hi guys. So I'm cutting up the zucchini. You're gonna wanna hold it tight and you don't wanna make the pieces too thin.
Okay.
Really watch what you're doing.
Now what are you doing?
Then you like, so then you cut it like into
fourths?
Fourths.
Okay. Or quarters.
Quarters. Yep.
Good job.
What are you doing,
Wyatt? Wyatt, what are you doing?
I am peeling the carrot.
Good job.
So I'm cutting up these carrots, and you want to cut them up where you put them into the circles, and you're going to cut them into halves.
We had to trade in our zucchini with squash because our zucchini was bad.
Half of it was bad, so we're just going to finish it off with squash.
Okay, I'm going to throw these ends away.
Wyatt, what are you doing?
I'm peeling these potatoes. We're gonna do the same thing we did to the carrot.
Here.
What are you doing over there, Wyatt?
Cutting up onion.
Dicing up the onion? What's your fingers?
And I'm cutting the...
celery.
Celery. I love celery, especially with peanut butter.
Done. We're the kids in the kitchen. We're the kids in the kitchen. We cook every meal from breakfast to dinner. We cook it for you and we cook it for us. We cook it fresh, fresh, fresh,
fresh,
and healthy,
fresh,
and healthy,
fresh,
and healthy,
fresh,
and organic. We just want you to eat healthy.
Let's get cooking.
All right, so today we will be making it's summer fresh corn and zucchini chowder,
which instead of we have part zucchini, part squash.
Our ingredients are a tablespoon of butter, 2 strips of bacon chopped.
We've already chopped them. We've already chopped
1 cup of chopped yellow onion, which we chopped, or about 1/2 of a large onion, 2 celery ribs chopped, 1 medium carrot peeled and chopped, 2 garlic cloves minced, 1 teaspoon dried thyme,
1 teaspoon,
2 medium ½-pound russet potatoes or 1 pound russet potatoes, peeled, diced into 1/2-inch cubes, 4 cups of water, 1 bay leaf, 4 ears of sweet, fresh corn, husk, silk removed, and kernel cut from the cob. 1 medium zucchini, diced in 1/2-inch cubes.
And we also used squash.
1/2 cup of 1/2 and 1/2. Or no, 1 cup of 1/2 and 1/2. Salt and fresh ground black pepper. And we are also using French onion mix. Right, chopped fresh parsley to garnish. Cayenne pepper to serve.
Optional.
We've already brought all of our ingredients over.
And we are in a large heavy duty bottom stock pot or Dutch oven. Melt butter over medium heat.
So we're going to turn on and 5.
Mm-hmm.
We're going going to take our butter. Pour that in.
Okay, so we're moving it around.
It looks like a hockey game.
Get that melting.
Wait, what did you just say, Wyatt? It
looks like a hockey game.
We're now going to get the bacon we have, and we're going to scoop it into a spoon and put it into the butter we just melted. And we're going to let it brown and render the fat.
Can we show them it melting? It looks so cool. It's just going around. Okay, guys, so when these begin to get brown, it'll take 3 to 4 minutes, and then we are going to add our onion, celery, carrots, garlic, and thyme, and then cook vegetables until they begin to soften, then stir a couple of times, about 5 minutes. Put them in. You can put that one in last. Okay, I think that's. And then we're going to put. We just put the onion in. Now we're going to put the celery in. But not all of it.
Yes, you can put all of that in.
Alright, so now we're going to put in all our carrots.
So we just put our thyme and garlic in. Now we're going to put our water, potatoes, and bay leaf in. This is how much water you'll need.
No, you'll need 4 cups.
4 cups.
There's the cup measurement.
Oh, okay.
I just brought it over there so you didn't have to go to the sink. There you go.
Okay.
Put that in it. One.
One.
Yep.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Four, and do a half, because those were not quite full cups.
Like that?
Yep, that's good. Okay, now you can put that in the sink. Leave the cup up here, though.
Alright, so now we're going to add our potatoes.
Yep.
Which I'm just going to jump in there. Alright, I'm
going to
put this in the sink.
Okay, now what?
We're going
to
put
reduced to medium, which is ours. Is I already reduced it to medium.
And we're going to let it sizzle.
Simmer. For how long?
Eight to 10 minutes. 8 to 10 minutes. We're going to add our bay leaf in now. We're using 2, but it costs more, but we're using 2.
Yep.
So we put our bay leaf in.
So we're going to add our zucchini and squash and corn. Right now.
Okay.
What? Can you come now?
Oh, that's all.
Nope, still.
All right.
So. Okay.
Right. So now we're gonna season it with our salt and pepper. Pepper.
Apply to taste, so you're just going to taste it once you've mixed it all around. If it needs more salt and pepper, just add more salt and pepper.
Okay, so we're about to put in our French onion mix, and we're going to put 1/2 tablespoon to 1 tablespoon.
Okay, put it in there. Then you want to mix all of that around, and what are we going to do then?
Once you put your French onion mix it, you're going to let it simmer from 8 to 10 minutes.
Okay, but stir it all in good first.
That looked yummy.
Stir it, buddy. You're just on the top. You've got to get in there and stir. Watch. Get your hand on there. I'm going to show you. There you go. Stir in there. Don't just push the top part around. There you go.
Alright, we are going to discard our bay leaf, which we already have.
Take out the bay leaves. Yep.
And then we are going to transfer 2 cups, which is 2 of these.
Yes. Watch out, because it's very hot.
Okay.
Dig all the way down because you need a whole full cup, bud. Yep, into the blender. And some liquid too, so get it all. Yep. Okay, and you might do one more because we've got a little extra than what it calls for. Okay.
Alright, now we're going to
blend it.
To puree until smooth.
Puree.
Alright, we're going to start the puree until it's smooth. So we turn
and slowly work your way up on the knob, slowly.
Where are we on?
You're on one right now.
Okay, we're on one?
Just turn it up a little bit. Yep, now go tip it back in.
Can I tip it back in, Wyatt?
Put that in the sink.
Can I tip it back in?
No. Let Wesley tip it back in. You did the blending.
Alright, we have it. Ew.
Wyatt, hop out of the way so I can see. Pour it back in, bud. And that's what makes the basis for your chowder.
Okay.
We've got some big chunky pieces. You probably ordinarily wouldn't have as much chunk as this has. But
yeah, I did that.
Do we use this one?
Yep. That's one cup. No, over the pot. Always do it over the pot, so if you spill anything, it's just going in the pot.
Oh, that looks like milk.
Yep.
Is it?
Kind of. Keep going till it's all the way full. There you go.
Now?
Let me see how big that carton was. Okay, so yep. We put the lid back on, and you're going to mix that in.
Ooh, look at that.
And just till it's heated through, and then it'll be ready to serve, guys.
Here. We're going to serve it up.
Bring your bowl over to it, bud.
We've got our ladle.
Yep. Ready to eat.
We have it right there.
Little parsley. No, not too much, bud. A little sprinkle on top. Perfect.
Mwah.
What was that?
Mwah.
All right, let's Perfect. Try it. Well, I guess let's come over here and try it. All right, boys.
Yum, yum.
Okay, you can try it.
Can
be hot.
Okay. Wait.
Oh my goodness, that is so good. It is? Let Wesley try it.